In a previous video, I showed you how to let Excel do the thinking for you. And in this video, I'll show you another example how Excel can help you do the heavy lifting. So if you've downloaded a spreadsheet, you've seen that there's a worksheet where we have all the recipes, all the things we sell in our little shop and how to make them. For example, for 4 servings of lemonade, we need 200 milligrams of sugar and 750 milliliters of water and 6 lemons. And of course, we can play with this a little bit. We can adapt our recipes and see what the influence of that is on our business. So I here have an experimental recipes worksheet where I've written down the recipes, but I've changed a little bit so that the ingredients are values that we can calculate with. And I also have a cost price for each of the items. And if I want to know what the cost price of 1 glass of lemonade is, I have to pairwise multiply the values and sum everything together. And luckily, Excel has a built-in function for that called sum product. So I just select the first range and the second range, and Excel will multiply and sum automatically. Of course, this is still the price for 4 glasses of lemonade, so I have to divide by the number of servings. So we can see 1 glass of lemonade costs $1.05. What is the sales price? Well, you've seen this a number of times, so we can type it, it's 250. But of course, we want to have a dynamic dashboard, so we'll use a VLOOKUP. We go to the sales price worksheet and we select the second column. And of course, you know this from the previous MOOC, we have to select false here to make sure we get the right value, even if we do some sorting. Now we can calculate the profit. This is just economy 101 by deducting the total cost price from the sales price. And we know the profit we make on 1 glass of lemonade is $1.45. Now here's where the experimentation starts. What happens if we change the amount of sugar in our recipe? Well, we know this. We have actually in the homework of last week derived a prediction for that. 150 plus 0.6 times the grams of sugar in our lemonade is how much sales we make. So now we can estimate the profit by multiplying the number of expected lemonades with the profit we make per lemonade. So if we leave our recipe like this, 200, then this is the profit that we make. But if we change it a little bit, let's say we make it 150, you see, it changes. We make a bit we sell less items, but we make more money because we save money on buying sugar. So you see, we sell more, we sell less, but we make more. And if we change it into 180, we sell a bit more, but we make a bit less. So the question now, of course, is what is the highest profit that is possible? What is the best amount of sugar in our lemonade, not taste-wise, but profit-wise? That's what we're going to figure out in the next video.